We actually met online, and I had been hinting all day at him taking me to lunch.
I don't catch on to things very easily. I didn't ask her out.
And so later on, I'm like, you know what? Let's just go get snow cones. He's like, awesome. I'll drive to wherever you want me to drive.
This is our first day. We went to a snow cone shack. We literally sat in the car.
I think for 5 hours, just talking about life, everything. He is so kind and patient. I get frustrated really easy, and he's just like, it's okay. He is like my rock that keeps me to the ground. So patient with me, so kind, and funniest guy I've ever met in my whole life. I've never met somebody who can make me laugh more than he can.
I was in Las Vegas for work, and she was in Louisiana still at our house by herself for the first time ever. I could hear it in her voice that every day she was not comfortable being by herself. For me, it's the fact that she grew to be by herself. She is an independent woman, but she needs me, and I need her. There wasn't a night that one of us didn't accidentally fall asleep on the phone. And we just left it on. We just left the phone on all night. It made me feel warm in my chest. I'm like, this is my person. There was a night she said something, it just made my heart melt, and I did it right there. I got on my phone and I went to Gage Diamonds and I bought that ring right then and there.
3, 2, 1, turn around.
Wow.
Oh, God.
Give it here.
Real, yeah, retweet.
Real.
So my sister had just had a baby, and Aaron had never ever held a baby before. So we passed off this itty bitty infant to him, and the baby threw up all over him. And instead of like freaking out, he was just like, okay, yeah, it's fine, I can do it. That moment in my head, I was like, wow, I want to marry you right now. At my house from Bay's is a 45 minute drive. And he would make that drive every single day just to see me. For 10 minutes, for 3 hours, he just wanted to be near me. I'm like, wow, I have never met somebody who would just do that for me. It felt like he was so committed to me. If I asked him to make the world stop turning, he would.
As they sent their vows to me separately, for me to read today, I could hear the heart in both of them. I could hear the joy and the satisfaction that they find in one another. Aaron writes, Cameron, from the moment we met at the Sugar Shack, I knew my life was about to change in the most incredible way. I promise to love you unconditionally, to cherish the moments we share, and to support you in all of our future endeavors. I vow to be your partner in crime, your rock when times get hard, and to share all of my work tea with you. To hold you close when things aren't going our way, and to pick you back up when it feels like you can't stand. I promise to be patient and understanding, to listen with an open heart, to communicate open and honestly, to create a safe space where you can express your thoughts and feelings no matter what. As we embark on this journey together, I pledge to build a life of love, kindness, and patience. I promise to grow with you, to be willing to face change together and build the relationship we both dreamed of. I promise to respect you as an individual and choose you every day and love you more than I did yesterday and less than I will tomorrow. With you, I have found my home, and whether they like it or not, a family to cherish. Today, I give you my hand, my love, and everything in between forever. I am honored to be yours and proud to be yours. Cameron, I love you more than words can express, and I look forward to spending our older years swinging on that porch just like we talked about. And Cameron writes, Aaron, from the moment I met you, I realized that you had no idea what you were in for. I'm not easy in any way, shape, or form. I vow to always let you sleep in. I vow to always finish your sentences and know what color you're thinking of. I vow to give you infinite support. I vow to take care of you in love, in sickness, and in health. I vow to be your best friend. I vow to give you all that I am and everything I ever will be. And when death takes my hand, I promise to hold yours in the other and find you in every lifetime. The groom and the bride have chosen to include in their ceremony a traditional hand fasting. This is symbolic binding of the hands and expressed by the terms, the bonds of holy matrimony. And to tie the knot, they are holding hands today on their wedding day, and they promise to love and hold each other's hands today, tomorrow, and forevermore. These are the hands that you will hold when fear or grief fills your mind. And lastly, these are the hands that even wrinkled and aged will still be reaching for the other hand, striving with the same unspoken tenderness, longing for that one special touch. Cameron.
Cameron.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
I choose you to be my wife.
I choose you to be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
Better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Aaron.
Aaron.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
I choose you to be my husband.
I choose you to be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poor.
For richer or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To have and to cherish.
To have and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
By the power invested in me by the great state of Louisiana and a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I would like to say, Aaron, you may kiss your bride.
Cam, you have been there for me through so much, through some really high highs and some embarrassingly low lows. I could not ask for a better person for one of my best and dearest friends.
This is everything I've ever wanted for you. The adventures you've had and the ones you will have, because the best is yet to come.
When the signatures on the certificates fade and the pictures in your wedding book start to get sticky inside from the pages being torn through, that's not what makes you married. What makes you married is choosing each other every morning you wake up, every night before you go to sleep. To marriage and to Cameron and Aaron.
tear me away.